Good morning. We're in England now. So we got into our hostel yesterday afternoon and promptly did nothing.
Yes.
Because we were exhausted.
Took about 10 naps. Intermittently.
Spaced out across the last 12 hours. Now we're here. And we're going to go check it out a bit. Just had our first meal at a traditional British pub. It's called the Queen's Arms. What'd you think?
It's pretty good.
Yeah?
It's really good.
You got super traditional English food. A hamburger. But it was really good. This is a 7-ounce patty and it was really nice. Like, it was clean and like well presented. And a really
very nice plating.
Yeah, plating environment. Super friendly staff. Just felt very comfortable. It's our last day in the hostel.
Our last full day,
yeah. We move in tomorrow in the morning. We didn't really film much of the hostel because A, we've been tired a lot, and B, it was really stressful getting in.
Yeah.
I misjudged the distance on Google Maps a bit. We found out that there was a tram stop right in front of the hostel, and we figured that out right as it was leaving that stop. So we overshot our stop by several blocks. And we're already tired. But for all intents and purposes, it's been really nice. We've been staying with Hatters. I guess they have a couple hostels in 3 or 4 cities around the country. As you can see, we have a private room, which is great.
Got here on Thursday morning, about 3 in the afternoon, I think. We got in around 11 or so, and we hung out at the airport for a little bit. I was super nauseous after getting off the plane.
Yeah, because you don't fly. Well, I don't even know if it's the flying, it's just traveling.
It's the flying, I think. Okay. It's just the movement of the flying. Mm-hmm. I have motion sickness really easily, so there wasn't a lot of turbulence, which was really nice. We flew to Iceland and had a layover there for about an hour, and then the flight from Iceland to Birmingham was fine, but I was super nauseous. I was done.
Yeah, because I mean,
moving
it's...
moving at 500 miles an hour.
It's a lot of time to be in the air. Like, I mean, compared to some people who travel a lot, I'm sure it doesn't seem like much. It was a grand total of, I think, 11 and a half hours travel time. Iceland's nice, by the way. I want to go back.
When we landed, they didn't have a terminal for us to deboard into.
Oh, yeah.
So our plane parked in the airport runway area, and we deboarded the plane into the tarmac. And then got on a bus and went.
Yeah,
drove around.
They have
the
probably 3 or 4 times as many planes going in and out of there as they do gates.
Gates, thank you.
Yeah, our boarding area had I think 4 or 5 different gates, and 3 planes were leaving at the same time.
Yeah, that was funny.
So we were all just kind of like trying to figure out which line to get in, and. You know, we got in this massive line. They all just converged.
Yeah.
And then there was one that was going to Belfast town. And they were like, final boarding call, come to this gate. And like a third of our line just kind of seeps out and goes into the gate.
It was different from when we boarded in America. I've only flown domestically in America. They call you by either you're in a class like A, B, C, D, or they call you by row number. And in Iceland, they did, I think, first class.
Yeah, like the
class,
premier class or whatever they call it.
And then everyone else. And so you just get in the line and wait to get on the plane. You just hope that nobody's in your seat.
Yeah.
I mean, they were still assigned seats, but when we got on, Jared was on the window and I was in the middle, and then the person that was sitting on the aisle was already there.
All in all, flights were good.
Yeah.
It was just, long for Becca. She and I are opposites. I really take to traveling. I love flying. I frankly love the whole process. It's just a lot of fun for me, and Becca does not like it.
So Thursday, we just got to our hostel, and we just kind of crashed.
Yeah.
I think you fell asleep at like 8.
Probably. I don't remember, which is telling.
I stayed up a little bit longer, but we got a good night's sleep. So then Friday, we went to the museum.
Yeah, Friday was our first day out and about. It was really nice, actually. The weather was lovely.
We saw some stuff. Pretty cool. We ate in a tea room.
You had amazing soup and salad. I had duck confit.
Yeah.
Which duck that's delicious with like pickled cabbage and greens, and
it was very cool. I think we'll go back again and take more pictures.
Yeah.
We didn't really take a lot of pictures because we just kind of wanted to
see it. Yeah.
And not really worry about trying to photograph stuff. That was a good chunk of our day. I think we were there 4 hours. So we just came back and took the rest of the afternoon and didn't really do anything. Mm-mm. I think I took a nap. We watched some BBC. Yesterday, Saturday, we walked around.
First, we started out by going to the Gastric Basin, one of the big canal districts. We wandered around there for a little bit, just checking out. It's really pretty. It's
really beautiful. Want to take a water bus tour?
Yeah, that'd be cool. Come back and do that. So after that, we're kind of thinking of things to do, and like, all right, well, let's go to Bullring, which is the big whole shopping area. There's an outdoor market. There's a food market that almost made Becca throw up because it smells like fish, and Becca doesn't like fish.
We walked in, and it was just all just stalls of different butchers and a lot of fish, and there's no ventilation. We just kept going in circles trying to find another part to go to, and it just didn't end. So we finally just left. I was very close to getting sick.
I don't mind it that much, but I am not nearly as sensitive to fish or even smell as you are. So that was part of it. Anyways, there's that. There's street stalls in the middle of everything, and then you get to St. Martin's and the Bullring Mall, which, again, massive. It's like three or four floors. It was raining at that time and very busy, and we were tired, so we didn't really hang around all that long.
We'll go back and get footage of it.
Because it is really beautiful.
Mm-hmm. So we came back in the evening, and then today, was that Saturday?
Yeah, that was yesterday. That was all yesterday.
Okay, today's Sunday.
We're caught up. We're caught up now.
Today's Sunday, we went to the Penn Museum.
It was really cool.
We didn't take any footage, but those pictures.
Yeah, for those of you not in the know, apparently Birmingham, for a good deal time, was the largest producer of metal pens and inkwell pens in the world. Like, I think they said something about 75% of all the pens in the world were made in Birmingham at one point in time.
Yep.
The history of things is really cool. Everyday things that you don't really think twice about.
Yeah.
It was like a bigger version, a more hands-on version of an episode of How It's Made.
That's exactly what it was like. It was a real life How It's Made.
Mm-hmm.
So this afternoon, I think we're just gonna kind of chill. Mm-hmm. And then we check out in the morning, and we're gonna meet the people at our apartment to sign papers, and then we'll move in.
We'll leave links to Instagram and Twitter down below, so you can check us out there, because we're still kind of getting used to this whole film thing.
Yeah.
But thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you later. Cheers.
Moving into our apartment today. We got all of our stuff packed up, ready to go. We're gonna take an Uber.
You're so quiet.
I am quiet.
You should probably speak up if you want them to hear you.
Maybe on Tuesdays. We're watching. What is it called?
Time Team.
Time Team! It's about archaeology.
Yeah. My attention is elsewhere.
Jared,
it's a TV show about archaeology. I mean,
Jared doesn't care about filming.
We don't have this in the States.
It's very cool. It's kind of chilly outside. I'm excited. We'll see you in a bit.